Good morning, children. Today I'll illustrate a few of the concepts that was told to you in the first video. It was said that A plus A transposed is always symmetric. So I have the matrix A here. So A transposed will be given by writing the first row elements as the first column elements. So first column is 2, 3, 5, second column 0, 1, 2, third column 2, 4, 3. This is our A transposed. A plus A transposed will be obtained by adding the corresponding elements of A and A transposed. So this element is 4, 3, 7, 3, 2, 6, 7, 6, 6. Now let us check. First column elements are 4 through 3, 7. And the first row elements are also 4, 3, 7. Second column 3 to 6. Second row is also 3 to 6. Third row 7, 6, 6. Third column is 7, 6, 6. Hence, A plus A transposed is symmetric. It was also told to you that A minus A transposed is always skew symmetric. Now let us find A minus A transposed. A minus A transposed is obtained by subtracting the corresponding elements of A and A transposed. So the first element is 0, 3, 3, minus 3, 0, 2 minus 6, it is 2 minus 4, which is minus 2, minus 3, 2, 0. So here all principal diagonal elements are equal to 0. A12 is equal to minus A21. A13 is equal to minus A31. And A23 is equal to minus A32. Hence, skew symmetric. Now, I have here a matrix A which is symmetric, and we are to find the elements of X, Y, Z, a few of the elements which are missing in the matrix given that it is symmetric. Now for a symmetric matrix, we know A is equal to A transposed. So on the LHS, I've written down A again, and let me write A transposed here, which will be 3, 1, X, Y, 7, minus 2, and 5, Z, minus 4. On comparing the corresponding elements, we get X is equal to 5, Y is equal to 1, and Z is equal to minus 2. So this is our solution. Here I have another matrix A, which is said to be skew symmetric, and we have to find the missing elements X, Y, Z. Find the values of X, Y, Z. Now we know for a skew symmetric matrix, it was said A is equal to minus A transposed. So A transposed is equal to 0 to X, Y, 0, Z, 6, minus 5, 0. So, A is equal to minus A transposed implies 0, 2, X, Y, 0, Z, 6, minus 5, 0 is equal to minus A transposed will be 0, minus 2, minus X, minus Y, 0, minus Z, 6, minus 6, 5, 0. On comparing the elements, we now have X is equal to minus 6, Y is equal to minus 2, and Z is equal to 5. So these are the values of X, Y, and Z. Next is, we are given a matrix A, and we have to express A as the sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. Now we already know that for any matrix A, A plus A transposed is symmetric and A minus A transposed is skew symmetric. So let us find A plus A transposed and A minus A transposed. A transposed is 5, minus 4, 7, 3, 6, 2 minus 4, 1 minus 8. This is our A transposed. So A plus A transposed will be 10 minus 1, 3 minus 1, 12, 3, 3, 3 minus 16. Is it symmetric? Yes, it's symmetric. A minus A transposed will be 0 minus 7, 11. Seven, zero, one, minus 11, minus 1, 0. Is it skew symmetric? Yes, it is skew symmetric. Now, if I add this symmetric matrix and this skew symmetric matrix, I have A plus A transposed plus A minus A transposed. It is giving me 2A. But I have to express A as the sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. So if I now multiply by half and divide by 2, I'll get A. So I can write down A is equal to half A plus A transposed plus A minus A transposed, which is half of A plus A transposed plus half of A minus A transposed. Write down the values and divide by 2. You will get the matrix A as the sum of a symmetric matrix and a skew symmetric matrix. Now, before I wind up for today, I would like to discuss with you all the properties of matrix multiplication, which is a little important. Now, matrix multiplication is not commutative. That means if I multiply the two matrices A and B, it is not equal to B into A. That means the order of the matrix, how I place the matrix for multiplication is very important. AB is not equal to BA. Now, if A into B is equal to A into C, it does not necessarily imply that matrix B is equal to matrix C. Matrix multiplication is distributive, which means A if into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. It is associative. A multiplied with B and C. This can be done. First we can multiply BC and then we can multiply it with A. Or we can first choose to multiply AB and then multiply C with AB. Keeping in mind that we have to keep the positions in the correct order. If A is multiplied, post-multiplied with an identity matrix, or it is pre-multiplied with an identity matrix, then the resulting matrix is always equal to the matrix itself. And the last condition is, if A multiplied with a null matrix 0 is equal to 0, it does not, A multiplied with a null matrix will always result in a null matrix. And if AB product of two matrix is equal to 0, it does not necessarily imply that A is equal to 0 or B is equal to 0. That's all for today. Practice all the sums which is given in the exercise. I hope you will be able to do it. And let's wait for the next video. Thank you.